Greetings, everybody. This is Emily from Of Pages and Ink, and today this is my second video, and I will be doing the villains tag that I was also tagged by Sasha because I have no friends. Anyway, so let's begin. First question is, villain you want to punch in the face. So I picked Sebastian from the Mortal Instruments series, because at one point I start to believe that he's actually not that bad, and I was like, you know, he may actually not be a bad guy. And he was, and I really want to punch him in the face because I fell for it and he deserves punishment even though it was my fault. A villain you can't help but love. President Snow from the Hunger Games. He is a great villain. Fantastic, because he's like a creepy villain. Like, he's this old guy that smells like blood and has like fish lips. I think that's how she portrays it, as fish or snake lips or something, but lips. And you know, he seems all, you know, gentlemanly and nice, but like you see the deeper meaning to his words and you're like, this guy is evil. So, President Snow, pick a villain you are bizarrely attracted to. I think pretty much anyone that has ever read this series can agree. The Darkling. Oh my god. moving on. Pick a villain who wasn't actually that mean bad. I missed the wasn't actually, and it switched in my head to isn't actually. I picked Belial from Angel Fall, and it's only because if you read this, he's actually pretty mean. But when you read this series, you kind of find out why, and you actually kind of feel bad for him and realize that he's not really a bad guy. It's just he's had it rough and it's had an effect on him. So I picked Belial. A villain you hated, side villain that you hated more than the main villain. Okay, this is a big spoiler alert. So if you have not read Red Queen, skip forward until you see the next book, because otherwise this is going to ruin pretty much the whole book for you. So I'm going to count to 10, and hopefully you will have changed the time to further in the future, and I might even, like, put my hands up so you can even mute me if you want to. And then when I'll go like this, that means come back. Okay, so the side character that I hated more than the main villain, or the side villain that I hated more than the villain, was Maven from Red Queen. Because Maven tore my heart out and threw it on the ground! Oh man, I was so mad. I was so mad. I consider the main villain the mom, even though I guess technically it turns out that Maven's the main villain. You just didn't know. But yeah, that's the one I pick. So I'm gonna do this. Okay, welcome back. Moving on. So the villain who was perfectly casted for the movie adaptation, I picked President Snow from The Hunger Games, who is played by Donald Sutherland. I was trying to pull it up on my phone because I couldn't remember his name. Someone I IMDb. President Snow. He's a great actor, and he plays President Snow awesomely. And there's even a thing that I saw, I want to say it was Nickelodeon Choice Awards. I saw it on Tumblr, like a clip from it or whatever, But he comes in and he, like, thanks the audience for voting for him as the best villain or something. And then he's like, I brought you all something. And he pulls Nightlock, not Nightlock. Yeah, Nightlock, right? The berries? It's Nightlock. He pulls the berries out of his pocket and offers them to the audience. It was the best. And when you have an actor like that that can really do that with their roles, it's perfect. It's perfect. I also think that the guy that they casted as Valentine in the Shadowhunters TV series is a pretty good, casting for Valentine, but I haven't seen his acting yet, so I'm not entirely sure. But based on what I've seen, I think he is. Okay, pick a villain who you thought was good at the start but turned out bad. So I'm going to hold up three books. Woo, I dropped one. That was the Darkest Minds. Clancy. Clancy I thought was good. No, Clancy's not good. Not good at all. Yeah. So, the Darkling. Spoiler alert, and Clancy. I do not have a villain that gave me nightmares. I don't actually really get nightmares, unless it involves a long dream about a zombie apocalypse where I somehow survive and then suddenly die. That happens. During tour, I get eaten by things, which kind of includes zombies, but it's also been other things in my lifetime. And having things attack people I love and have them die, I've had multiple dreams where my mom gets killed by snakes. I don't know why. I don't want my mom to be killed by snakes. I'm never mad at my mom when I have those dreams, so it's not like my brain is subconsciously trying to kill her. I don't know. But other than that, I really don't really have nightmares, which I guess is a good thing. But I have really, really weird dreams. They're weird. Anyway, so that's the last question. I tag anybody that wants to do this because, like I said, I only really have Sasha as a BookTube friend. If you're interested in being my BookTube friend, put a comment below, say hi, say hey, how you doing? Subscribe and I will subscribe to you. You have to be, well, I guess you don't have to be a booktube, but I prefer booktube right now so I can have some booktube friends. And yeah, so I will see you guys in a bit because I will be doing my Haunting of Sunshine Girl book talk / All Hallows Read books 1 and 2. Yeah, so see you guys.